Now, before we begin, we're going to cover some basics here. The first being, what is a thumbnail? Well, thumbnails are images that represent your video and give viewers a glimpse of what the content is going to be about. Places where thumbnails show up are generally on the YouTube sidebar, after a video has played, embeds on a website. Say you visit a website and there's a video there, you click play, and before you click play, you'll generally see a thumbnail for that video. Social media outlets, the YouTube homepage, and of course, when your subscribers get emails regarding your uploads, so they will see a thumbnail that represents what the video is about. And typically, some subscribers, not all of them, will actually click on the video, but if you entice them with a very good looking thumbnail, that is another way to increase your view count. So it is important. It takes effort and practice, of course, to get the form of thumbnail creation down, but with practice you can do it. Anybody can do it. When I first started, I had no idea what I was doing, and eventually I got the hang of it and started to make better and better thumbnails. And it definitely takes some kind of practice, but like I said, anybody can do it. And this kind of brings us to our next section, which is creating a thumbnail. Now, I do have a specific video, about a 10-minute long video in this course, that goes from a blank canvas to a final product in terms of a thumbnail. I create a thumbnail in Photoshop from the very beginning to the end. If you just want to skip to that, feel free to do so. But creating a thumbnail, generally you're going to use some kind of image editing software or program such as Photoshop or GIMP. Of course, there are alternatives out there, but Photoshop is generally the one most used by people on YouTube and other graphic artists, and it's one I would highly recommend to get good at. It's a very strong thing to have in your arsenal, not only in creating thumbnails but also creating videos. So Photoshop, while it might be overwhelming at first, I would highly recommend checking out tutorials. There are a ton of them online, pretty much teaching you anything you need to know about Photoshop, whether that be how to do special fonts, how to cut out an image, how to place an image on a background, how to cut out a background, etc. There's so many tutorials and resources out there at your fingertips. You just have to search for them, and most of them are great. Of course, you will find some that don't really teach you anything, but there are a lot of great tutorials out there that I would highly recommend. Now, Photoshop does generally cost a pretty penny. Older versions of Photoshop are cheap and sometimes even free, so I would recommend checking out those first. If you don't want to go that route and you want the newest version of Photoshop, they do have a monthly payment type thing set up where you can pay like $10 a month to get access to Photoshop, which is something that is somewhat recently new, and it is actually really cool. Now, there is also the 30-day free trial that Adobe offers on all their products, whether that be Photoshop, Premiere, Lightbox, everything that they offer. You can try it out and see if you like it first, and then decide to move on from there. If you want to purchase it, if you want to do the monthly payment type thing, you can always do that. But I would highly recommend checking out Photoshop. If you don't want to go the Photoshop route, my other suggestion is GIMP, which is completely free from the get-go, and you can install it and have the whole program and all its features right from the start. Now, these, like I said, are only a couple options. If you just do a simple Google search, you can pull up a plethora of different programs, but these are the ones that I have experience with and that other people use on YouTube.